हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद, वंदे मातरम। वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू योर क्लास रवि सर जी मैथ्स, द इजियर एंड बेटर वे टू लर्न द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 9 टू 12th विथ एडवांस मैथमेटिक्स। स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टुडे वीडियो लेसन्स, वी विल लर्न हाउ वी कैन प्रिवेंट आवर सेल्फेस विथ नोवल कोरोना वायरस। स्टूडेंट्स, यू विल हैव टू कीप इट इन माइंड फ्यू स्टेप्स through which you can save yourself and your family with this pandemic. Students, first of all, regularly and thoroughly clean your hands with an alcohol-based hand rub or wash them with soap and water. Maintain at least 1 meter or 3 feet distance. Avoid going to crowded place. Avoid touching eyes, nose and mouth, because hands touch many surfaces and can pick up viruses. Make sure you and the family around you follow good respiratory hygiene. This means covering your mouth and nose with your bent elbow or tissue when you cough or sneeze. These dispose of used tissue immediately and wash your hands. Stay home and self-isolated even with minor symptoms such as cough, headache, mild fever until you recover. Bring some supplies. If you needed to leave your house, wear a mask to avoid infections. Other, if you have a fever, cough, difficulty breathing, sick, medical tension, but call by telephone in advance if possible and follow the direction of your local health authority. Keep up to date on the latest information from the trusted source such as WHO or your local and national health authority. Hope students, you have understood and you can spread this message to all your relatives, all your friends, all your elders, such that you can prevent yourself with this novel coronaviruses. Okay students, before starting today's video lesson, if you are new to this channel, just subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Okay students, our today's topic is complementary event. Students, here we will practice how we can find out the probability of complementary event. Suppose the component of complement of A denoted by A dash, A bar or A complement consists of all the outcomes in which event A does not occur. The relation is P of A plus P of A complement is equal to 1. Otherwise, you can formulate P of A is equal to 1 minus P of A dash. Depending on the problem, it may be easier to find P of A dash than use the above equation to find out P of A. Students, here you can see that P of A denotes that the thing is happening. What? The thing is happening, and P of A dash denotes that the thing is not happening. Students, suppose you are tossing a coin, you are getting head, this is P of A. You are not getting head, this is P of A dash. The sum of P of A and P of A dash is always 1. Okay students, this relation can be formulated in 3 ways. Initially, P of A plus P of A bar is equal to 1. Students, P of A is equal to 1 minus P of A, otherwise P of A bar is equal to 1 minus P of A. Student, all these formula we can use in different question. Okay students, let us see with an example. Suppose you are throwing a die. If you are throwing a die and you want to find out the probability of getting even number, right? So students, you know that 2, 4 and 6, all these are even number, right? So what will be the probability of it? 3 by 6. Suppose you don't want to get an even number, so what you will do? पी ऑफ ए डैश इट मीन्स वॉट यू आर नॉट गेटिंग इवन नंबर. सो वी नो दैट पी ऑफ ए डैश इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस पी ऑफ ए. सो पी ऑफ ए इज 3/6. सो यू कैन रिमूव 3/6 फ्रॉम 1. सो फाइनली यू आर गेटिंग 3/6. इट मीन्स द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ नॉट गेटिंग इवन नंबर इज 3/6. सिमिलरली स्टूडेंट्स, here you can see that let A be the event of spinning R, then the correspondence of A is not R. It means students, A dash is equal to what? Y, P, G, B. Similarly students, we are going to practice more questions. Let us see the next question student. In this example students, here you can see that box containing 5 white, 3 black, 2 red balls. In getting one ball, what is the probability that it is not a red ball? Okay students, again here we want to find out the complement or probability of a complemented event. Suppose students, we know we want to find out not getting red. It means what? 1 minus probability of getting red. Right students, you want to find out not getting red ball is equal to 1 minus P of red means probability of red ball. So P of not getting red ball is equal to 1 minus 2/10. 2/10 means students there are 2 red ball and number of total red ball are 10. So you can calculate all these things. So finally you are getting 8/10, which is simplified by 4/9, and 0.90 it can be converted into percentage. So there is 90% of not getting red ball. Similarly students, let us do few problems. The first problem is what? Suppose if you having question like that way, P of A is equal to 0.35 and you will have to find out P of A bar. So students, we know the relation of P of A and P of A bar. Earlier we have studied that P of A plus P of A bar is equal to 1. Now students, here you can see that what is the value of P of A? The value of P of A is equal to 0.35. and P of A bar is our target, is equal to 1. So students, P of A bar can be written as 1 minus 0.35. Now students, 1 can be written as 1.00, right? 1.00 minus 0.35. Now you can subtract 0.35 from 1. So finally you will get what? 0.65. So this is our final result. So students, similarly we can calculate few more questions. Let us rub these things. Okay, the next question is, there will be similar question students, so don't worry. Don't think that you are not understanding these questions. If you are not understood the first one, you can understood the second one. If P of E bar is equal to 0.01, find out the probability of P of E. By mistaken, here you will have to find out P of E, right? So we know that the relation P of E plus P of E bar is what? 1, right students? So we want to find out P of E. So what is the value of P of E bar? 0.01, this is 1. So P of E can be written as 1 minus 0.01, right student? So 1 can be written as 1.00100 minus 0.01. So P of E will be 0.99, right? Hope you students, you have understood this question. Okay. Let us rub this question. Now moving to the next question, student. Now students, the next question is, if P of E is equal to 0.357, find the probability of P of E bar, right? So we know the relation P of E plus P of E bar is equal to 1. So P of E is equal to 0.357 plus P of E is equal to 1. Now we want to find out P of E bar. So formulating P of E bar, so 1 minus 0.357, so P of E bar can be written as 1.000 minus 0.357, right students? Now 0.357 can be subtracted from 1.000. So 10 minus 7, 3, 9 minus 5, 4, and 9 minus 3, 6, right? Okay. Now moving to the next question. Students, be ready with your notebook and pen so you can continue writing in your notebook with calculation. Okay students, now the next question is question number 4. If P of A is equal to 3x and P of A bar is equal to 2x, right students? So here you will have to find out P of A and P of A bar. Students, we know the relation P of A plus P of A bar is equal to 1. Now you can substitute the value of P of A and P of A bar. So what is the value of P of A, 3x, P of A bar, 2x is equal to 1, right? So 3x plus 2x is equal to 5x, so x is equal to 1/5. We want to find out P of A, but the value of P of A is equal to 3x, right? So here we can put the value of x, so finally we will get what? 3/5. Okay. We want to find out P of A bar also. So P of A bar is equal to 2x. Now you can put the value of x over here. The value of x is 1/5. So finally you are getting 2/5. I hope you students, you have understood this solution of this question. Okay, let us rub this question. Students, once again I am telling you that just be ready with your notebook and pen. Students, in question number 5, if P of E is equal to X and P of E bar is equal to 3X, so again you will have to find out the value of P of E and the value of P of E bar. Students, this is similar to the question number 4. Again, you will have to write the relation. We know that P of A plus P of a bar is equal to what? 1. So what is the value of p of a? Here you can substitute in place of a e, because here we have considered the event is e. So the value of p of e is x, and the value of p of e bar is equal to 3x. So x plus 3x, 4x. So the value of x will be 1/4, right? What we want to find out? P of e. So p of e is x, so the value of p of e will be 1/4. P of e bar is equal to 3x. So you can put the value of x over here. The value of x is 1/4. So finally you are getting p of e is equal to 3/4. Okay students, now moving to the next question. The next question states that, question number 6, if p of a is to p of a bar is equal to 2:5, so find out the value of p of a and p of a bar. Okay students, we know the relation p of a plus p of a bar is equal to what? 1, right? So first of all, from the data we will find p of a and p of a bar separately. So p of a is to p of a bar is equal to 2:5. So p of a by p of a bar is equal to 2/5. Consider this ratio is equal to 1 x, sorry. So p of a will be what? 2x, and p of a bar will be what? 5x. So from the relation we know that p of a plus p of a bar is equal to 1. Now substitute the value of p of a and p of a bar. So value of p of a is 2x and p of a bar 5x, 7x. So x is equal to 1/7. Now we can substituting in p of a is equal to 2x, so 2/7, right? And similarly p of a bar is equal to 5x, so value of x is 1/7, so 5/7. Now friends, moving to the next question. What does the next question states? Suppose if p of a is to p of a bar is equal to 1:5, right? So find the value of p of a and p of a bar. Student, this is similar to the previous one. So we know that from the data p of a is to p of a bar is 1/5. So here we can write p of a is to p of a bar is equal to 1:5. So p of a upon p of a bar is equal to 1/5. Consider this ratio is equal to x. Now so p of a will be what? 1x, right? P of a will be 1x, and p of a complement means a bar. will be what? 5x. So we know the relation. P of A plus P of A bar is equal to what? 1. P of A plus P of A bar is equal to 1. Now substituting the value of P of A and the P of A bar. The value of P of A is what? X, and the value of P of A bar is 5x. So we are getting 6x. X is equal to 1 by 6. Now putting the value in P of A. P of A is equal to X. So X is equal to 1 by 6. And similarly P of A bar is equal to 5x. So 5 in place of x, writing 1 by 6. So finally we are getting P of A bar is equal to 5 by 6. Okay, now moving to the next question. If P of A is equal to 1 by 4, find the probability of P of A bar. So students, we know the relation. P of A plus P of A bar is equal to what? 1. So P of A is 1 by 4, P of A bar is unknown, is equal to 1. We want to find out P of A bar. So making the formulating P of A, so we are getting P of A bar is equal to 1 minus 1 by 4. So by simple calculation we are getting P of A bar is equal to 4 minus 1 means 3 by 4. Now students, moving to the next question, this is similar to the previous one. If P of E bar is equal to 3 by 8, we have to find out the probability of P of E bar. We know that P of E plus P of E bar is equal to 1. So putting the value of P of E, by mistaken here it is been P of E. Okay, so P of E is equal to 1 minus 3 by 8. So simplifying these things, so P of E is equal to 8 minus 3. So finally we are getting 5 by 8. So P of E is equal to 5 by 8. Okay students, let us practice few questions regarding our previous video lecture. Students, here you can see that you will have to pick a card from pack of 52 cards. So what will be probability of getting jack? So students, we know that there are 4 jack out of 52 cards. So finally the answer of the first question will be 4 jack. So 4 by 52. A club. So we students, we know that all the cards are divided into 4 part: club, diamond, spade and heart. So there are 13 club card, so the probability will be 13 by 52. So you can simplify. A king. Students, we know that there are 4 king out of 52 cards, so the probability of getting a king will be 4 by 52. Similarly, queen having 4 cards, so the probability of getting queen will be also 4 by 52, not a picture card. Students, we know that jack, queen and king means 3 cards of jack, 3 cards of queen and 3 cards of king. There are 12 cards of picture card. So we don't want to find out the probability of getting picture card. So we can subtract 12 cards out of 52 cards. So there will be 40 cards which are not pictured cards. So 40 by 52. A king or a queen. So 4 queen and 4 kings. So there will be 8 by 52. Similarly, students, you can calculate other question. Now moving to the next question. The question is that a chance of throwing a 2 with a die. So students, we know that if you throw a die, there are you can get 6 different number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So getting 2, so 1 by 6 chance of numbers under 4. So 1, 2, 3 are the less than 4. Similarly, students, you can calculate all these problems. And here is the sheet for probability. You can find out throwing a dice. Okay, students, in this sheet we have earlier solved these kinds of problem. If you are throwing two dice simultaneously, we can get 36 outcomes, and on the basis of the data we can find out the probability of different events. Okay, students, here we are completing today's video lessons. I hope you have understood this video lesson. For more video lesson of this chapter, keep watching your channel Ravi Sir G Maths. Thank you so much for watching this video.